In this example, we are given that a solid conducting sphere of radius A having a charge Q is surrounded by a conducting shell of inner radius 2 and outer radius 3A, as we can see in the figure. Now, the inner sphere is also connected with the outer shell via switch S, and it is asking find the amount of heat produced when the switch is closed. Now, in this situation, if we analyze the charge configuration, we are given that a charge Q is given onto the inner sphere. And we know that the whole of its flux will terminate on the inner surface of the outer shell. A charge minus Q will be induced over here and a charge plus Q will be induced over here. Now, in this situation, an electric field lines or an electric field will exist from inner to the inner sphere to the inner surface of outer shell and from outer surface of the outer shell to infinity. Now, if we close down the switch, we know that the whole of the charge of inner sphere will flow to the outer surface of the outer shell to keep the potential of the two equal. In that condition, when the whole charge will flow to the outer region, we can directly state the electric field within the annular region from radius A to 2A will vanish, because earlier this electric field was in existence because of the charge on the inner sphere as well as on the negative charge which is induced on which the lines are terminated. However, this minus Q is not producing any electric field inside. Now, when the switch is closed, whole of the charge will flow to the outer surface, and due to which we can say as the total charge of the system remains same, the electric field in the outside region will remain same before and after closing the switch. Because earlier also this electric field configuration was due to a positive Q charge which was induced on the outer surface, and after closing the switch, these two charges will neutralize and still only a charge plus Q will exist, which we can equivalently say that the charge of inner sphere is now transferred to the outer surface of the outer shell. And total electric field will remain same in the outer region. So only the electric field in the annular region will vanish. So here we can say, on closing the switch S, amount of heat produced is basically the loss in energy, which can be written as the field energy earlier stored in region from radius A to 2A, because earlier there was an electric field from A to 2A and finally no electric field exists in this region. So, this amount of heat can be calculated by integrating the field energy from radius A to 2A. So, this will be from A to 2A, and it is half epsilon naught E square. Electric field can be simply written as KQ by X square whole square multiplied by 4 pi x square dx, which is an energy stored within the elemental shell of radius dx at a distance x from center. Within this elemental shell, the energy is this, which is integrated from A to 2A. So, this can be directly calculated. Here, 1k gets cancelled out with 4 pi epsilon naught. So, the remaining term will be kq square by 2. Integral from A to 2A, it is 1 by x square dx, because 1 x square will get cancelled out with this x square. So, on integrating, we are getting kq square by 2. Integral of 1 by x square is minus 1 by x. We apply limits from A to 2A. And on substituting limits, finally, we are getting the result as kq square by 4A. That will be the answer to this problem. You can solve this problem with one more method, that is by difference of the energies. This heat can also be written as initial energy stored, total energy stored in the system minus final energy stored in the system, which can be calculated by self and interaction energies of all the charges of the system. This I am leaving as an assignment for students, just to calculate the initial total energy of the system final total energy of the system by summing up all self and interaction energies and take the difference. This will further give you the same result that you can also solve and verify.